All right, we're at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites in Houston, Texas. And today we will be doing a hotel tour. Fitness center. So here is the fitness center.
That is ever a gift from God.
He's still stressing out.
Of course I am. I'm supposed to be.
It's pretty good. It has three treadmills, two of these machines, and a bicycle. And
Father King Getty, I'm like 9 years old, my dude.
Truth, but me got you a bike. See, with this, you make your.
And then there's a bench right there and a weight machine. I don't know what's in there. And here's the weights. A medicine bowl and some other things. There's some copyright things playing on the TV, so I'm gonna have to talk over it if I can.
How am I supposed to compete with that?
I mean, I don't know. Am I supposed to?
And then here are the towels and the water machine. No, these used towels.
I'm all for changing the day off, but being forced to not work is even worse than working. Which I also don't do.
So yes, dude, this is a very nice fitness center. I've seen nicer. There's a Holiday Inn Express that's actually not too far from here. I also did a hotel tour, and I think that one did have a nicer fitness center, but this one isn't too bad either. Now we look at the laundry room. It is open 24 hours. There we go. So here's the laundry room. So you have two washers, two dryers, or I think, yeah, those are actually the washers. Those are the dryers. Obviously, you have to pay to use them. Use at your own risk. So yeah, it's a pretty basic laundry room, but it is nice to have, especially if you're staying for an extended amount of time. It's always nice. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the laundry room. Now we'll check out the pool. This very nice courtyard. And then there's the pool, which sadly it's locked because it's pretty late out right now. I'll show you. If you see her. Yep. It is. Oh. It's true. It says left hand. Oh. Yeah, it still doesn't work because it is currently closed. But this is a really nice courtyard. I really like the design of this place. Very beautiful. It's very modern too. I mean, it's a little bit older, but still very nice. All right, let's go back in and we'll take a look at a few other things. So this is the elevator. There are actually two. The one, there's another one on the other side. This is a Schindler 3300. Basic elevator, nothing much worth seeing. And unless you're a fan of 3300s, I guess it could be cool. And of course, slow leveling. Door closed does not work, which is surprising for 3300s. They almost always work in 3300s. Oh, this might be a 3100, who knows? We'll switch up at 4. And that's actually where the room is. The other elevator is exactly like this. Before you ask, yes, I know all my hotel tours so far have just been of Holiday Inn Expresses. That's just the only hotel tours I've been able to take so far. Sorry. These are a little bit older, I think. This hotel in general is... I can tell it's slightly older than, like, ultramodern. Now I'll do the... I'll go to the room and then I'll do the room tour. There is a room 444, actually. So we are in room 438. Your evacuation plan. And there's your extra locks. And there's a peephole. Here's a mirror with traveler safety tips. So first let's look at the bathroom. Here's the sink. So this is an interesting kind of sink because the faucet works like this. So I just felt like showing that. So here's the toilet. And here's the shower. I guess we'll turn it off. And there's your shampoo, conditioner, shower gel. So it's a pretty nice bathroom. It's very modern too. Here's the fridge. And then a Keurig machine. And then your microwave. And here is a chair, and then a little table, eating table. And there, here's a good look at the room. So here's a closet with your safe. That's a pretty nice safe. Then you have your iron machine and iron table, ironing table. Here are the beds. Here's the TV, which I'll just turn on for a little bit. So it's... there's no guide or anything, it just... there's a little channel guide and you press the numbers and which one you want. So let's turn it off for now. And here's a little table right here with an alarm clock and a phone. A little guide to the area and stuff. And then the Bible. And then here is a couch, which also has a, you know, one of those beds that are fitting into it. And there's another painting. Let's see, is it... let's turn it on. So here's a desk, another mirror. And another phone. And this is interesting, they actually provide an Ethernet cord. Unfortunately, my laptop does not have an Ethernet port. And then there's another table, which was in front of the couch, but we had to move. And here's the view. Pretty nice view. And then the air conditioning unit. Let's see. No, that doesn't do anything because it's controlled by the wall thermostat over here. So I think that's pretty much the entire room for now. Not much more, really. And it is bigger than most of the rooms I've stayed in before, but it's not like a full-on suite or anything. So I guess I'll do the hotel review here. So this hotel is actually located quite a few miles south of the other Holiday Inn Express that was in Cyprus that I also did a hotel tour of. And comparing this hotel to it, I'd say that this one is nicer, but not by much. For one thing, the lobby area, as you could see earlier, was much nicer. It was much more spacious, there was more area to eat, and I think the breakfast was better here. The hospitality was alright, like I saw some people cleaning out there, but like the employees were like, I mean, they're respectful and stuff, but I don't know. But yeah, they were definitely, I think they were better than the other Holiday Inn Express, though. One thing I did not like is how the elevators were placed. There was one on each side instead of there just being two right next to each other. I don't know why, I prefer when all the elevators are in one place. But I guess the good thing about that would be that, you know, you have an elevator for one side of the hotel and elevator on the other side. I also really like the courtyard pool area in this hotel a lot more than the other Holiday Inn Express, because the other one's more generic. Though I do like the other Holiday Inn Express's fitness center better. Overall, I'm gonna give, and also, these rooms are very modern, but I think the other Holiday Express is slightly more modern. And also, I don't know, I just don't like that sink design. I see a lot of flaws in it, but. So overall, I'd say the hotel, both of them have their ups and downs, and I feel like, and yeah, this one is older. This is when they're transitioning to the more newer style Holiday Inn Express. Because I reviewed an older one, I reviewed in a very, almost brand new one, and I reviewed kind of one in the middle, and this is the one in the middle. Still very nice property, and I'll give it a 9 out of 10 for, you know, there's just a lot of good about this hotel. There's only a few downs here and there, but really they don't hamper the experience. But yes, it was overall a very nice stay, and I do recommend it. Anyways, that's it for this hotel tour. I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, I'll see you all in the next video.